Hello dear students, welcome back to online English and German classes. Today we will study the last lesson written by Alphonse Daudet. Alphonse Daudet was a French novelist and short story writer, and the background of this story, it happened during Franco-Prussian War of 1870 to 1871. Now, what is Franco-Prussian War? Franco means French and Prussian means German. Actually, those days, it's a long story and part of history, Germany was called Prussia. So here it means Franco-Prussian means French German War of 1870 to 1871. In fact, from 1866 to 1871 Germany fought three wars, and in those three wars, first Germany defeated Austria, then Denmark was defeated, and in the year 1871 Germany defeated France. As a result of defeat, or as a result of the treaty, France lost two of its provinces, namely Alsace and Lorraine. So now in these two provinces of France, there will be the medium of instruction will be German, not French. You remember when the British came to India, the official language became English, and before that, when Mughals were here, the official language was Persian. So that's natural, you understand that. Okay, so this is about the author. Now the first paragraph of the lesson, here the narrator of the story is a small boy, maybe 12 or 13 year old boy is there. I don't know whether it is mentioned somewhere or not. His name is Franz, F-R-A-N-Z. So Z will be pronounced as S. Franz. So the narrator of the story is a young boy, Franz. Franz is late to his school and he is afraid. In the first line, you read in great dread. So please underline that phrase, in great dread. Okay, of a scolding. Franz is very afraid of Mr. Hamel. Mr. Hamel teaches French language to them. And Mr. Hamel has given the verb forms to learn, okay, to the children. And Franz had not learnt it. That's why he is afraid of being beaten. Nowadays, we cannot touch students. Okay, so those days, students got good beating and they became good human beings as well. Okay, never mind. Okay, so whenever Franz was not ready with his lesson, he would remain absent from school, okay, and there were so many things to look to go, like they can go after the birds, or sawmill was there, okay, that day Prussian soldiers were drilling. Why were the Prussian soldiers drilling? They were rehearsing, you know, the after this was the last class, and from tomorrow itself or today itself, the German soldiers were supposed to take over this class, this school, okay? That's why the Prussian soldiers were drilling, they were rehearsing to take over, okay? Before a performance, they rehearse, okay? It was a military exercise, okay? So he felt like remaining absent from school, okay? What motivated Franz more than his classes or learning of participles was the chirping of birds or the sawmill or the drilling of the Prussian. Okay, so these kind of things. I also felt like that only. Whenever I had any problem in mathematics, the teacher never, like, we were afraid to ask anything. Okay, things have changed drastically now. Okay, so he felt like remaining outside. Anyway, in paragraph 2, we come to know that when he reached there, he was going to school and he saw a crowd in the town hall. Town hall, you can visualize here, town hall in every district, there is a town hall. Here in Gorakhpur also we have a town hall. So there was a crowd in front of the bulletin board. Okay, bulletin board is for what? For news. Dear students, now this bulletin board you can underline. Okay, why? Because you may not understand. Why may you not understand this? Why? Because nowadays we have so many media of information. See, I do not read. For the last 6-7 years I have not been reading any newspaper or any news channel, nothing, but still I am always updated what's happening around in the world. Why? Even if you don't want, you are not interested in that, you like your ears will be crammed with the news and you will be able to know. Means to say that so many media of news is there, but those days no newspapers, nothing, no televisions. So whatever official news, official information had to be there, they would get it from the town hall bulletin board only. Okay, every time now. So you understood? Any confusion you can write in the comment box. Okay, so here one thing we come to know, that for the last 2 years something happened. What happened for the last 2 years? And what this last 2 years, though in the book it is mentioned about the war between 1870 to 71 only, but here it is shown for the last 2 years. It means that the news came, or the France was engaged in war for more than 1 year. Okay, as I already mentioned that it began in 1866 only. Anyway, so all the bad news came there. What kind of bad news? From the news bulletin, sometime there would be news of that in some battles our soldiers have lost. Sometime there will be some change in the, like, some new orders would be there. Okay, some orders from the military. Okay, and I thought myself without stopping, what can be the matter now? Sometimes it would be that there is going to be some recruitment of the young boys as young as 14 years old for the country needed soldiers to fight. Okay, so now every time some negative news was there. Okay, then he, okay, so that was what we also come to know about, what kind of news they would get from there. Okay, now as he was in a hurry, because you know France was also late to school, he was always late to school, so he was trying to hurry. So there was a man, there was a blacksmith, his name was Watcher. There was a blacksmith and his name was Watcher, and he was there with his apprentice. Who is apprentice? Apprentice is your assistant. Okay, so he said to Franz, the young boy, "Don't go so fast, bub. You will get to your school in plenty of time." Now, why does he say, dear students, we know, or dear readers, we know that Franz was late to school. We come to know that Franz was late to school, and yet Mr. Watcher, the blacksmith, tells him that don't go so fast. You will get to your school in plenty of time. You can underline this. Okay, why does he say so? Why? Because Mr. Watcher, the blacksmith, knows some secret news that Franz doesn't know. And what secret news does he know? If you know, you can write in your notebook. Otherwise, in the end, I will tell you, disclose it to you. Okay, there is something that he will not get scolded. Okay. But Mr. Watcher, the blacksmith, knows something, and that's why he's telling Franz that don't go so fast, you will not be late, you will be in time. But we, the readers, know that he was late. Now, why so? Okay, Franz doesn't know that. He thinks that, or he thought that Mr. Watcher was making fun of him because he was late. And he reached Mr. Hamel's little garden all out of breath. Now Mr. Hamel is there. You can also call it Mr. Hamel, no problem. So Mr. Hamel is there, little garden. So has he gone to his house, his home? No. This little garden, actually, Mr. Hamel had been working in that very school for the last 40 years. For the last 40 years. And that school was like his own house, okay? It was like his own home, okay? Not house, but in fact a home. Okay, he has maintained a garden, he has planted many trees, he has maintained it in a proper way, like his own house, okay? Understand, no? So he has, like, emotionally he was attached with the school now, okay? So he reached there. Now, dear readers or dear students, here Franz tells us, Franz, the young boy, please don't forget the narrator, he is the young boy, okay? So he says that it is the usually whenever the school began, and I also remember when I used to study, when I was there in class 3, so we would learn the same lesson and we were supposed to learn very loudly in unison, means together in uniformity we had to learn. Some of us made sound, we didn't learn anything there, okay? Some of us at least, okay? So usually when school began, there was a great bustle. Bustle means great noise used to be there because all the children were learning their lesson at the highest pitch, okay? You could hear far away in the street, you could hear it, okay? And then there would be the closing of desk lesson repeated in unison, very loud, and you know, hustle and bustle and noise. This was the usual scene. And also you could hear in the street far away from, I mean, not very far away from school, from some at some distance, that the teacher would be beating the desk with his iron scale, okay? But that day it was so still, so silent, it was quiet. Why was it so quiet? Why no noise, no hustle and bustle, no learning of lessons that day? Everything seemed quiet, okay? So please underline this thing, had counted on. Here had counted on, I had counted on the commotion to get to my desk without being seen. Franz thought, actually he had planned that he would take advantage of that, had counted on the commotion, that he would take advantage, or he would take the cover of commotion or a lot of noise, and the teacher, Mr. Amel, would not be able to see France. But it was not so. Everything was quiet and silent. So it was as quiet as a Sunday morning. And why Sunday morning is quiet, you understand, because it is a off day, holiday. So generally people wake up very late. So this is very quiet on Sunday morning. There is very too much quiet. Okay. So Mr. Hamel, generally, okay, you forget that, leave that, okay. So that did so happen that as he opened the door, he was very afraid as usual, because he was not ready with his lesson. He would be scolded by Mr. ML, the French teacher, that was what he was visualizing or he was thinking. But nothing happened. He is shocked. Why Mr. ML is not scolding me? He saw him and said very quietly, unusually, okay? It was his unusual behavior. It was not the usual behavior of the French teacher. Go to your place quickly, little Franz. We were beginning without you. Never before did he speak to any of his students like that, okay? So he went to his bench and he could not understand why everything was silent and there was no noise, okay? Nobody was learning his lesson, okay? And that was about his school, about his class, that no noise was there, everyone was silent, okay? And he noticed something special, something unusual about the clothes of his teacher as well, that the teacher had on his beautiful green coat he had put on, okay? So why that beautiful coat? He remembered that it was not a special day, nor Republic, not Independence Day, or the birthday of the teacher, or it was not Inspection Day. Why at all? So beautiful shirt and the little black silk cap all embroidered, and then he never wore except on inspection and prizes days, but this was not any of these special days. So why at all did he wear these special clothes? So that is what Franz, the little boy, also the narrator, notices about his teacher, that his teacher, his French teacher, Mr. Amel, has worn very beautiful clothes, which he generally wore on some special occasions like prize distribution, inspection of school, or any other days like that. Okay. Now, that was not enough, or that was not the end of it. When he looked back, he noticed on the back benches. What he noticed? Generally, the back benches used to be empty. But that day, it was not so. The back benches were not empty. The village people, they were sitting quietly like ourselves. Who was there? Who were there on the back benches? Old Hauser was there. Okay, Hauser is the name here. Okay, old Hauser, old man he is, with his three corner hat, he was sitting there. The former mayor of the city was also sitting there in the class as a student. That the former postmaster, the retired postmaster, all the retired people were sitting behind on the benches. So dear readers or dear students, just visualize this thing, that on some day, if those old people of 70 year old or 80 year old people come with their old book and sit with the small children of class 6 or class 5th, how will the class look? So that was how the class looked. Okay. Everybody was sad. Franz could not understand why everybody was sad. And Hauser had brought an old primer. That primer is that when you begin learning something, that is primer, your book in lower classes in UKG or LKG, thumbed at the edges, please underline that. Thumbed at the edges here means that is worn or soiled, or the pages have torn from the corner because of use. And it's so old, no? When he was a child, he used to read that. Now he is old, 70 year or 80 year old, and held it open on his knees with his great expectations lying across the pages. So that you have to visualize how an old man is sitting there on the bank bench with his old book. So Franz could France was not able to understand what was happening, why so many unusual things he was noticing in his class, about students, about his teacher, about the old people sitting behind. Okay, so as he was just wondering about it, Mr. Amel, the French teacher, he mounted his chair and then he addressed the children. My children, this is the last lesson I shall give you. The order has come from Berlin to teach only German in the schools of Alsace and Lorraine. The new master comes tomorrow and this is your last French lesson. I want you to be very attentive. So these were the words of the French teacher informing the student that this was going to be the last class, the last lesson, and after that what would happen? French will not be taught anymore. Why? Because their master now, the only German will be taught in the schools of Alsace and Lorraine, because these two provinces, Alsace and Lorraine, are no more the part of France. Okay, they have been annexed by the German authorities. Now, what a thunderclap these words were to me. What does it mean? This sentence is very, very important. Thunderclap. Here France is welcoming the words of his teacher. But you know, France's attitude to the teacher's words and the books. Okay, but before that, the second line is there. Oh, wretches, that was what they had put up at the town hall. Now, dear readers or dear student, do you remember the bulletin board? I told you something that Mr. Watcher, the blacksmith, knew. And this was the reason why Mr. Watcher, the blacksmith, told Franz, the young boy or the narrator, that he was not late to school. Okay, now Franz, the young boy, the narrator, understood. Oh, the wretches, the villains. Who are the villains? The Germans. Okay. Now the villains or the wretches, they had put that notice on the town hall, the bulletin board of the town hall. Okay, this is going to be my last French lesson. And Franz was never serious about learning his language. Okay, and now he is afraid that he was not going to learn his own language anymore. Okay, he would be without his own language, his mother tongue. He was afraid. He was sorry. He must be sorry. Who was responsible for not learning his own language? Okay, so now Franz reflects upon his past days instead of going to his school. He remained absent and went after the birds' eggs or going sliding on the Saar. Saar is the Saar Valley. It's one of the valley. Okay, there. And the books, he never liked his books. Franz never liked his books. Okay, he thought it was so boring, history is so boring, and that participle, the language, grammar class is very boring, so dry class. And the bag is very heavy, very boring books are there in the bag. And the teacher, the most boring face in the world every day. But now that he realized that no more he is going to learn his own language, mother tongue. So that is what that is what our attitudes to what we have. Here I remember the words of Helen Keller, that people who have eyes, okay, who have eyes and they can speak, you know, they take for granted, okay. But you ask Helen Keller the value of these things. So the things which we get in free, or we have to work least for something, we take for granted, okay. And when we have to work for something to get something, we know the value of it. So Mr. Amel, he has spent 40 years of his life in teaching these children, but they were never serious about that. Now that they were, now even if they wanted to learn their own language, they could not learn it. So now they understood the, now France, like other French children, all those old people, he realizes the value of his own mother tongue, his own language. Once it used to be so boring and so boring, and the bag used to be so heavy, but the same bag, same book or same face of the teacher, now all became like old friends, and he it seemed that he cannot remain without his book or bag or the voice of his teacher or the face of his teacher. Okay, so it all depends time. And Mr. Hamel too had an idea that he was going away. Okay, so that was the time to say not bye but goodbye. Now Franz was able to understand why all the old men from the village were sitting in the back of the room. Okay, they were also, why were they sitting there behind on the back benches? Why? Because when they were, now you will wonder, if they did not learn their lessons, how did they become the mayor or the postmaster or the actually, dear readers or dear student, those days happened. You passed your 7th class and then you got a job, you got a service, government service institute. Okay, more I will tell you. Okay, no problem. Okay, you got it now. So it was because it was a way for them. They came to pay respect to the old man, to the teacher, Mr. Amel, the French teacher, who had been working hard for the last 40 years of his faithful service, and of showing respect for the country that was theirs no more. And now the country, now where they were living, they had to leave those provinces immediately. So now they came to know the value. Okay, so now Franz was reflecting upon his past days as he was lost in imagination. He was thinking about all his past days, how he used to spend his time. He was called by the teacher to recite . But he was, as usual, he was not ready with his lesson. So when he was not ready with his lesson, he felt ashamed, and he just holding on to his desk, he didn't dare to look up. Okay, he was ashamed. Now Mr. Amel, the French teacher, was not angry. Rather, very politely he addressed him. "I won't scold you, little Franz. You must feel bad enough." Yeah, now the Germans will rule you. You will understand the value of your own language. That's what Mr. Amel, the French teacher, wants to or may mean. See how it is. it is this type of practice is there everywhere. Every day we have said to ourselves, ah, I have plenty of time, I'll learn it tomorrow. In fact, this is universal. Everywhere we are like that only, okay? Plenty of time is there, we will do it tomorrow, okay? Okay? But now you see, no tomorrow will be there. And you know what is happening to ELSIS? Every day we think that, okay, tomorrow we will learn again. Tomorrow we said that tomorrow we will learn. So trouble with ELSIS, it means that all people living in ELSIS, they have this kind of tendency. Whenever they are asked to learn something or do something today, they will say that they have enough time, they will do it tomorrow. But Mr. Amel, you should know that people in Gorakhpur or anywhere in any part of the world, we are also like that. We think that enough time is there and we will do it tomorrow. And how time flies, we don't know. And when we become old, we realize, "Arre, I should have done this or I should have done that." Okay. So here she puts off learning till tomorrow. Here Mr. Amel uses she for the province of Alsace. Okay. It stands for the people of Alsace, that we are in habit of postponing everything for tomorrow, till tomorrow. Now no tomorrow would be there. Shame on you. Shame on you. Now those fellows out there, the Germans, they will laugh at you. The Germans will laugh at you. How? Arre, you pretend to be French and you cannot speak your own language. Shame on you. You should know your language. Okay. Now that is one aspect. Second thing, but you are not the worst, poor little France. We have all a great deal to reproach ourselves with. So please underline to reproach ourselves with. Now, the teacher realizes that it is not only the students who are responsible for not learning their lessons. There are other parties as well. Who are the other parties responsible for not letting the students learn their lessons? We. So who are we here? One is the teacher and one is the students' parents. How? Your parents were not anxious enough to have you learn. Why? Why the parents of those children were not worried or serious about their studies? Okay? They sent their children to work on farm. It was known that those days the child labor was allowed. So they went there and earned some money for the family. So they preferred, or you can understand that, we can understand that education was not so popular. The people, the parents were not so aware, or the education was not so popular, it was not so common. So people didn't, most of the people didn't think of educating their children. Okay, they were interested in money, so they sent their children to work or to get some money to support the family. And the teacher blames himself. Why? Because he realizes now that whenever he was in mood to go for fishing or doing his hobby, anything like that, he would tell the children, "Go home, you can go home." So that is what, that is how they were not able to learn their lesson. And whenever the teacher felt like that, okay, go and water the plants in the garden. So here the teacher, the French teacher, Mr. Amel, doesn't blame the students only, rather he himself takes the blame, okay, and he blames the parents as well. So all the three parties are responsible, okay. Now, French language, let us know more about French language. What is French language? French language is the most beautiful language in the world. Dear readers, dear students, according to you, which is the most beautiful language in the world? Of course, your mother tongue. One's mother tongue is the most beautiful language in the world. The clearest, the most logical. Emotions in the best way you can express in your own language. I have seen very intellectual people, highly educated people, well-versed in English and French, but whenever they have to talk with their own folk, they use their own language. Why? Because they are not able to express. They may pretend to be knowing French and English and other languages, but the emotions you cannot, no way you can express your emotions in some foreign language, okay? So one's mother tongue is the best, okay? The most beautiful language of the world. Never forget it, okay? When a people are enslaved, so all people he has used. All people he has used, all people here means a nation, a country, okay? So when a country, a nation, a people here, a people means a community is enslaved or are enslaved. As long as they hold fast to their language, it is as if they had the key to their prison. Okay? If you don't lose your language, there is chance that you will be free one day. For example, Jews, JEWS, Jews. Or the Jewish people, they didn't have a country before 1945. They were in diaspora, they were dispersed, scattered in different parts of European countries mainly. But you know, they spoke their ancient language, Hebrew, no matter which part of the world they lived, but they never ceased to speak their own language, the most ancient. Spoken language, okay, Hebrew, and now they have their own country. They were united by language and they have their own country. So, language is our identity, okay. Then he opened the grammar book and then all would learn it together, okay. I had never listened so carefully. Now you understand, it's very natural. It was going to be the last class. And it was not possible for one day, like for the last 40 years he had been teaching and they were not serious, they didn't learn. It may simply not be possible for one to make you learn in one day only. But it seemed like that whatever Mr. Amel, the French teacher, knew, it seemed that he will teach everything to the children. So emotional he became. Okay, after the grammar, they had a lesson in writing. So the lesson in writing we will do next day. Thank you very much. And the remaining part I will do in the next video. Thank you very much.